Good Tuesday morning. Not just any Tuesday. It's the first Tuesday in September, which means, oh boy, it's back to school.
Back to school time.
Thousands of kids, the three big school districts in the Twin Cities, sending their kids back to school.
Yeah, it's a big day. So many parents have been so excited for this day. They're like, bye. You know, a lot of parents, the tears will be shed at bus stops
of course.
Today, I'm sure, too. We do have team coverage as Minnesota heads back to school. CeCe, she's a new hope as districts enter year two with bus driver staffing issues.
First,
Guy
though.
Brown, though, yeah, he's busy.
Coon Rapids, you have your first day forecast, the bus stop forecast, so to speak.
Yes, all the students at home watching, getting ready to jump on the bus stop. Happy first day of school to you. I'm live here at Coon Rapids High School, where it's a great day to be a Cardinal. And again, stick with us throughout the morning. We're going to have some students right behind me making some noise, showing off their high school pride, showing off their pride. But first, you got a few clouds to start this morning at the bus stop, and I'm starting to see some mid-level clouds here with a little bit of some sunshine maybe peeking through. But by late morning, I'm talking about abundant sunshine too. A great day on the way. Recess later on for the bus ride home. We'll see some passing clouds under partly cloudy skies. A-plus weather today. Enjoy the first day of school. Weather will be cooperating with us as well. You got temperatures this morning right around 62. We are still seeing mostly cloudy skies here. So I do think most of the cloud cover high level, mid level. So the sunshine to start this morning filtered. So stick with us throughout the morning. I'm live here again at Coons Rapids High School. But for now, Alicia, back to you.
Cardinal Nation, we'll check back soon. Thank you, Guy. Looking at the metro map, all green for now, but again, anticipate roads to be a little busier today as a lot of parents will be going to drop-offs. Watch those school speed limit zones, of course, if you're driving through your neighborhoods, but no crashes around the Twin Cities metro, and drive times still looking good.
The day is finally here. It's the first day of school across the metro for thousands of students. For some students, there's just minutes to go before heading back to class. The big three districts, Anoka, Hennepin, Minneapolis, and St. Paul, all welcoming students back this morning.
Thousands of students are going back with fewer teachers and support staff, though, thanks to a nationwide shortage.
Now districts are getting creative in the classroom to fill hundreds of open spots.
I can tell you that I heard just last week of an elementary teacher that's going to be teaching science classes and of a principal that's going to be teaching as well. So it's all hands on deck.
And here's a closer look at the shortages within the metro. St. Paul Public Schools needs 80 teachers to be fully staffed. Minneapolis needs over 250. And in Anoka, Hennepin, there's less than 175 openings for educators across the district.
With thousands of metro students going back to the classroom today, getting your kid to class is priority number one.
That's right. This year, a lot is being done to make sure that you don't experience another bus driver shortage like we saw last year. And that includes giving out huge hiring bonuses to attract new drivers.
CeCe is live in New Hope with how some services are trying to keep drivers around. Hey, CeCe.
Good morning. We're here at Durham School Services this morning, and it's one of many local bus services that have been working all summer to attract new drivers, but also keep the ones they have. Leaders here tell me that they've been doing that by doing huge hiring bonuses for new drivers, and they are pretty hefty in the price. Take a look at what they're offering.
Welcome to Bus 241.
Dave Herzuk is more than ready to welcome back students this year.
We'll be welcoming about 9,500 students on the first day of school.
He's been driving for Durham School Services in New Hope for a little over a year now, coming out of retirement for a special reason.
Actually, my grandson is a student in the school district, and he didn't have a ride last year.
So Dave spent hours training, hoping to be a part of the bus driver shortage solution.
We all have played kind of a unique role in the challenge of educating kids these days.
Now that a new school year is here, school districts are working hard to make sure what happened last year doesn't happen this year.
We're in a much, much better place. We've been working hard all summer long to recruit drivers.
That's General Manager Clinton Holder. He says Durham School Services is offering more than most to hire drivers and keep the ones they have.
We're offering a $2,000 sign-on bonus for somebody without any experience, and then a $5,000 bonus for somebody with existing CDL experience.
That offer is a big hit. They already have 82 drivers, but are still looking for about 20 drivers to jump on board. While the cash is a big draw, Clinton says you also can't pass up their environment.
To be the greener grass that people are looking for.
As for Dave, he hopes more people will join the team so they can experience the same joys he's experienced while behind the wheel.
A lot of fun stories, a learning experience, but in the same breath, it was a great opportunity to serve the community and our children and our youth in such a unique way.
Yeah, so Durham School Services picks up students from the Robbinsdale area schools. So if you're interested in applying, we have more details about how on our website. And coming up in about 30 minutes, we're actually going to be talking to a bus driver getting ready to go pick up some kids on their route. So we'll have that for you coming up very soon, guys.
All right, CC, we'll check back soon. Thanks for that report.
The new school year marks a return to more normalcy when it comes to COVID. All kids 6 months and older can get a COVID vaccine. It's not required in Minnesota schools. Minneapolis, St. Paul, and Anoka Hennepin have all dropped mask and social distancing requirements. All the districts say they'll be flexible to changing state or federal guidance.
And the U of M Minneapolis is welcoming back thousands of Gophers today. Expect to see more Minnesota State Troopers around the city as well. State Patrol tells us they'll have increased patrols through Friday from 4 until midnight. And we have you covered for everything back to school. All you have to do is just send us a text. Send the word school to 763-797-7215 and we'll text you back with all of our coverage.
Yeah, but that blood got straight. What's gonna happen? Whoa!
Just into the newsroom overnight, brand new video of fighting and chaos outside the state fair as it closed up for the year. A viewer sent us this video. You can see people pouring out of the gates and even hear a firework or two go off. It's the latest round of chaos in the area to end the fair. This morning, a teen is recovering after a shooting near the state fair.
It happened last night near Arona and Como just after 8:30, and that's about a half mile from gate 6 at the fairgrounds. Police tell us an 18-year-old was shot in the torso. He was rushed to the hospital and is expected to be okay. Our crews on the scene say there were several bullet casings scattered across Como and Snelling Avenue. No arrests have been made.
This shooting just 2 days after a man was shot inside the fairgrounds Saturday night. This morning, investigators are trying to figure out who pulled the trigger and how the gun got into the fair. There are metal detectors at entrances. Officers tell us they were working because other items were stopped from coming in.
This morning, a Bloomington family is facing homelessness after a fire. It happened near 97th and Cavell, which is right off of Highway 169. Bloomington Fire sent us these pictures from overnight, and thankfully no one was hurt. Crews tell us they are investigating what sparked the flames. The Red Cross is helping that family who lost their home. Well, sad start to the school year for students and staff at Maplewood Academy.
The Crow Wing County Sheriff's Office tells us a 30-year-old staff member was pulled from the water at a youth camp in Brainerd yesterday. The man was on a retreat at North Star Camp with a group of students. Deputies say the students pulled him out of the water. He later died at the hospital.
Golden Valley will have a new police chief by the time most of you are done with dinner tonight. Virgil Green's swearing-in is happening at the Golden Valley City Council meeting, which happens at City Hall at 6:30. Green's been in law enforcement for 38 years. He's worked in New Mexico, Oklahoma, and Arkansas.
Rolog, a small town west of Detroit Lakes, went back in time over Labor Day. Over the weekend was the 69th Western Minnesota Steam Threshers reunion. Each year, thousands of people go to the event, going back in time to see how steam-powered machinery once helped farmers. Organizers say people come to, quote, relive the tradition of the good old days.
The good old days. Yeah, it's a fun event for sure. Kids love it, too.
It's cool seeing those old, you know, farm tractors.
How they worked.
Yeah.
I'm surprised some of them still work.
They probably put a lot of work into it throughout the year just to get it to run for that afternoon.
Keep it working for sure. Well, we need to get back outside on this Back to School Tuesday, a shot over Minneapolis. It's a great start as thousands of kids are going to be heading back to the classroom across the metro. Let's get out to Guy, though. He's in Coon Rapids. Oh, he's got some Cardinal swag.
Wearing the colors.
Yeah, I traded in my Care 11 polo for a Cardinals shirt, and it's a great day to be a Cardinal. Again, I'm live here at Coon Rapids High School this morning, giving you live weather reports, so stick with us throughout the morning. We're going to have great weather for the first day of school. Take a look at the bus stop forecast for the kiddos jumping on the bus. A few clouds this morning with temperatures right around 64, sunshine by recess 75, warming up to 80 by the bus ride home, but my forecast high today right around 83. So we'll max out right around 83 with some passing clouds later on this evening. A-plus weather today with temperatures starting off in the low 60s. And we do have some clouds overhead. I'm starting to see some mid-level clouds, high-level clouds. So you'll notice the cloud cover with a few peaks of sunshine early this morning. Dew points nice and comfortable in the 50s. So here's your three-day forecast, because temperatures are going to be warming up before cooling off. So kind of a weather roller coaster ride, starting to turn a little bit more humid later on as humidity rises for the afternoon hour, still in the upper 50s, low 60s, so slightly humid on the skin. Most won't really feel the humidity, but tomorrow and Thursday, you may, because temperatures will jump up to right around the mid to upper 80s, and then we'll start flirting again with that 90 degree mark by Thursday. Thursday will be the warmest day on the 7 before cooling off and rain chances late in the week. So stick around for my 7-day forecast. That is coming up next as the dry stretch of weather continues. Also, again, that brief warm up today, tomorrow, lingering through about Thursday. We'll be cooling off for Friday, and then rain chances increase for Thursday night. We'll have those rain chances increase into Friday. So Friday does look like a wet day, wipers working Friday, and don't forget the umbrellas come Friday. So stick around, that's all coming up here in my 7-day forecast.
All right, sounds good.
Good reminders. I want you to learn the fight song for the next time we check in with you, Guy, okay? That gives you about 10 minutes or so. Coming up, the new COVID booster shot is available in Minnesota. We'll tell you everything you need to know about the new vaccine that's coming up in 5.
And in just 15 minutes, we'll be live with St. Paul Public School leaders. CeCe Gaines will also fill you in on everything you need to know when sending your kids back to school this morning.
And in the spirit of back to school, look at this. It's a first day back to school picture of CeCe.
CeCe. Oh, she's so cute.
That's our own CeCe Gaines. Send us your first day picture, 763-797-7215.
Adorable. Well, she didn't have the side pony.
No. Here.